In the sky, it's a bird, it's a plane. Flying high, I emerge through the flames. Have no fear, I'm here, so stand back. Melanin activate, the name is Super Black. In the sky, it's a bird, it's a plane. Flying high, I emerge through the flames. Have no fear, I'm here, so stand back. Melanin activate, the name is Super Black. Imagine that, a future that's super black. Long as your skin brown, your superpowers intact. What would your powers be? Just hope it ain't super whack. Spatial manipulation, create a portal that's black. Maybe just super speed, time travel to run it back. Or chi manipulation to keep my spirit intact. As I encounter evils the world face, demons the world makes, I needed the world to stay. Rest in peace to Chadwick, they killed all the Black Panthers. Told us white lies, I still marvel at black answers. Suits in D.C., pray it lead to a civil war. It ain't no Justice League, what's the need to be civil for? Propelled like the juggernaut, it's clear ain't no stopping this. The world in grave danger, who can stop the apocalypse? They killed all the heroes, the new ones don't really care. But if you need me, put your fist up in the air. Yeah, in the sky, it's a bird, it's a plane. Flying high, I emerge through the flames. Have no fear, I'm here, so stand back. Melanin activate, the name is Super Black. In the sky, it's a bird, it's a plane. Flying high, I emerge through the flames. Have no fear, I'm here, so stand back. Melanin activate, the name is Super Black.
Hey, yo, what's going on? It's another episode of Blerd's Eye View. We thank you for tuning in. It's your man on the wall, Chris Fury, along with your boy, DC the Hooded Wonder. What's going on, D? He's still getting things together.
Oh, that's why they killed Roger Predactor.
There it is. Whatever, whoever that is. What's going on, man?
Didn't ask that. My bad. I was watching Ace Ventura last night.
Oh, shit. Okay, that's wise.
Yeah, you got it. Yeah,
Ventura. What's been happening, man? What's been happening?
Let's see. I need to shout out Defining Excellence, Celeste Brown and Leah Brown. They are two black sisters who own a vending machine. It's a retail vending machine.
Oh, yeah.
It's the dopest idea I've ever seen in my life. So shout out to them. Their 1-year anniversary was last Thursday, and I was invited to a fantastic networking and mixer and event. So can't wait to have them on with the shit to talk about their journey into that. Other than that, man, major networking, things going down. I can't wait to talk about it, but I can't talk about it. So, moving on.
What's going on? So, if you're watching on here right now on YouTube, Twitch, or Twitter, or Facebook, you already know where to follow us. Of course, you can also listen to us on the Opulence Radio app, and you can also check us out on iHeartRadio and anywhere else you listen to your podcast. But right now, there's somebody I want to bring in. Oh, but before I do that, I got to play this. This was dope.
Today, woman, will you turn your back on me? Foes can't shoot through my open souls. I close lanes when touring the open road. When I open shows, change your channels, grab remote controls. Overload for hopeless souls who know we're dope with souls like drones. Filming overdoses of smoking bowls. Keep the smoking pros, causing social woes. And show no emotion like gold masks with a poker pros. When I talk these tones, these words collide like broken homes. These vocal tones, smoother than Papa was a golden stone. Yeah, in other words, dope things for quote things. Every time I spit a verse, bar started loping. Compound so mean to pro tools for low teams. Whole foods for codeine, and wear them like some OGs. That's provoking your whole team that I'm insulting. It's an omen, getting in line like Coke Stream coating. I'm ODing, this just OPM. Bestowing blessings like confessions from the ODM. Composing ODM. Yeah. Today.
Prowess.
Woman, will you turn your back on me? Oh,
That was Starsky and Hutch from her new album, From Prowess to Testament, Sky Goddess, Legend of the Moon. Let's bring her in. That's Prowess to Testament, everybody. What's going on?
Ah, yes. I'm great. How are you?
That was... I love good hip-hop. What can I say?
Yeah, y'all do good hip-hop on this show, for sure.
I appreciate it. So, before we get into your albums and the plethora of work you got going, because that was tough, let's cover some of the Blerd news real quick, why don't we? Yeah, get that pulled up real quick. Yeah. So if you are a fan of the Powerpuff Girls, if you are a fan of Foster's Imaginary Home for Friends, Craig McCracken just announced that he's bringing the show back. And he's going to be bringing it back. And we're going to look at the, and it's, he said it's going to be a little different than the last version, which was came out in 05. But obviously he said there's going to be some takes on some of the old stuff along with some of the new stuff. And we're looking at some. Let's face it, if you don't like the Powerpuff Girls, there's something wrong with you. If you don't like Foster's Imaginary Home.
I can decode that. So, in other words, they ain't going to beat the shit out of Mojo Jojo like they used to, because now you can't do that.
Good point.
Because now it looks a little racist if they beating the shit out of
you. Oh, so, yeah.
They got to change that and beat the shit out of, what was that, Fuzzy Lumpkins, they gonna beat the fuzzy, fuzzy Lumpkins.
Beat the shit out of a billionaire. Man, not black on black crime.
Yeah,
you can't You can't have that, right?
You can't be beating a monkey, but a fuzzy hillbilly. Yeah, we can get away with that nowadays, I guess.
Right, right.
Yeah.
DC, you're right. They lost more subs.
I tried to tell people.
Netflix lost over a million subs in the last quarter.
Nobody listened to me. I was a crazy black dude when I was like, it's going to keep going. They're going to lose everything. And I'm here for it.
Oh, you were right.
Now they're trying to charge you an extra $3 if you share your password on top of already charging you $42 for high definition. That makes no sense at all.
True. Yeah.
This is true.
They should have kept the sharing. They should have kept the sharing to expand having like their a family plan of some sort that would have been like
they've been trying to get the dollar, and it's like, yo, y'all had the foothold and y'all thrashed it
for high definition. Mm-hmm. And not everything is high definition,
right?
Exactly.
But they charge you for age 40, like what was it, they kept going up, like each year they kept going up. It was 12, then it was 15, then it was 17, now it's 42.
It used to be $3.
Well, it used to be $1, you get the shits in the mail, but, you know, they got ambitious and thought that because they took Blockbuster out, they was the thing. And not knowing
they were for, and they were for a while. Yeah.
They got too
and then
close
karma.
To the sun.
Yeah,
too close to the sun. Poor Icarus.
Karma just caught up with it. Like, yeah, you guys. And it's going to keep going because they are not with the times anymore. Like,
I think this was part of the reason why they're starting to pump out the movies that they have, because it's like, look, just get them out. Just get them out, because we don't know what it's going to look like at the end of the year.
I guarantee you right now.
If they mess up, I think they have something special, because I really am about to try to see if I watch Resident Evil, and I'm thinking about restarting my subscription just for that. But if they mess up on it, I know that it's not canon and I don't care about that. I'm like, I want to see Albert Wesker played by Lance Reddick. And I, you know,
yeah,
that for me is important.
Can't be.
She's finally
resurfaced.
I mean,
from the surface of the sun of Texas.
Hello. I love your hair color and your makeup.
Oh,
you're so beautiful.
You. Thank you. You too. I love all of your cosplay. So yeah.
Thank you.
So, this is something I know.
Christmas is sitting in the back, just not saying anything. Hey, Candy, how you been? No long time, no.
Why is he still here, by the way?
Oh my God.
And I hate to do this with a guest because I try to act like I have some sense because we at home. We don't need to be cutting up at home.
I'm here like Netflix. I'm just hanging on by hope and a prayer that you niggas just keep me around long enough for $42 for my definition and some badass movies with horrible actors.
Got it.
Oh my God.
Oh my gosh.
Well, it's not really news, but the actor who plays Fitz said that if Kevin Feige or anybody from the MCU asked him if he wanted to be, if they wanted to do the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. movie, show, whatever, he would say no. But his reason was just, he says the ending that him and Simmons got at the end of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. was a happy one. And he would hate to have that messed up and rebooted.
Tell the truth, you get money somewhere else.
Exactly.
Yeah, he probably is.
I hate when people do that. They can just say you get a bag somewhere else and it's better than what they're going to offer you.
They say it in legal jargon and contracts, but they just can't like say it. But it's written somewhere.
That's exactly what it sounds like. I'm already committed to something and
I got
I'm
a project coming out.
Non-competing.
Jeez.
Exactly. Like, I hate that.
So Prowess, what is it? What anime are you watching? What comic are you reading? What cartoon besides looking for, I guess, dipping your toe in the water for Resident Evil on Netflix?
Child.
Oh boy. So it depends. I feel like so daily it varies. I got my Belmont Tape shirt on right now because I am rewatching Castlevania.
That's right. Amen. Let's get some claps going for that. Amen.
Yeah, you know, it's interesting because I started replaying.
It's fantastic. I love that show.
Yes, and season 4 on DVD just got released, so it's a perfect time for me to actually buy. And I've restarted replaying Symphony of the Night, so I'm like, this is for me. It's a little bit of like coming full circle. You know, you want to be able to align your stuff. I try to make sure I do that. Align what I'm watching. I feel like for comics, so it really depends. My son is really, really dominates, I think, comic books in the house now. So mm-hmm. It really, he is obsessed with all the, I'll say this in a good way, all the things he really shouldn't be reading. in the Sandman, and like he will like read stuff that I'm like, I'm not really sure if, you know, where, because I did it, right? So it's almost like I feel really weird saying,
oh, conflicted. Okay.
Yeah, I don't want to tell
you. It's always weird when you're the parent and then you see yourself doing what you did and you're like, I want to check that, but also,
hey. Exactly. What do you, I don't, like, I try to connect with other parents about it to be like, how do you, you know, how do you kind of censor but not censor? Because I wouldn't recommend him reading Sandman, but like, I try to suggest that like he does stuff that's not as dark, but he won't listen. Like, he will read Hellboy. You know, the Seed of Destruction all day. And
now, were you a child that listened?
Yes. So I feel like we just, you know, and I think it's also seeded by me a little bit because he knows that I like it. So it's hard because, right, you want to have conversation with your parent about what you like.
That's true, too. And you like to keep that communication open. Best piece of advice I got from a coworker, shout out to Fuji if you're watching. Years ago, I was complaining about my son, and I was like, not in a bad way, but just being like, man, he's so much like me. Like, what is going on? I wasn't like this at this age. And she's like, you are not raising you at that age. You are raising you now. So the influences and everything we have going on now, that's why my kid has the mouth he does, has the brain he does, moves how he does, likes the anime he does. Because I'm like you, where I'm like, hey, don't watch blah, blah, blah. And the next, you know, it's like, well, let's just both get started on Tokyo Ghoul, shall we? Because we're here now.
Right. We're here now. And then watch Assassination Classroom, and then what do you do?
We're here.
In the peer group. See, I think it's important, too. The peer group is watching stuff. And so it's like, if everybody, our neighbor across the street is like total into Demon Slayer, my son really hasn't gotten into it yet, but it's coming. Because they're going to need to have conversation, right? So it's like, I already know this is, what do you do? Let it go. And I like
it. Watchful eye over it is the best course of action. I mean, like you're doing it now. You're already doing it. Like you're obviously the worry part is there. You already know. I'm like, okay, I'm just gonna keep a watchful eye on what he's watching until it becomes. You might not be ready for that one just yet, but here's something else that might take that.
That is crazy. Huh? My dog, my son told my dog to shut your black ass up.
No, now where did he find that?
Right, right.
That's why I said I heard me.
That's how you see it now.
Definitely have a conversation about that later. I can't be mad because it's me, but at the same time, serendipitous did that come up right now.
Oh, right.
She kind of stays in the house a bit. It's like, I don't want you to be at school. Like, shut your whatever ass up. But
no, he ain't going to do it at school, but I know why he did it, but at the same time. All right, moving on.
Good old parenting. Good old parenting. Yeah,
parenting 101 from DC. Coming to the fall.
It's so much different when you have to watch stuff after a certain time.
Yeah.
You know, or play something, you know, is interesting because I do want him to explore that and be able to make decisions a little bit, you know, the executive functioning it takes to be like, should I be, or at least learn how to hide it. You know what I mean? Like,
oh my God, I'm heavy on that. Hide certain stuff. I don't, because we had to hide and sneak when you just. Yeah. The issue I'm running into now, girl, my son's too truthful. So he'll flat out tell some stuff sometimes. And me and my man are sitting up there and we're both thinking you really could have got away with something and you just told the truth. And he's going to be 15 this year.
Okay. Okay.
He just told the truth. Like he wanted to go to the park one time, but it was really to go to the park to watch some girls fight and then get into some other stuff after. He flat out tells me. And I was like, you could have just said, I wanted to meet up with my
friend. We don't have the womp-womp. We don't have the womp-womps now.
No, we were sitting up there like, bruh, you ruined your whole little afternoon.
Right, exactly.
I like that he's being truthful. Way, but at the same time, it's just like, dog.
You got to be like, come on now.
Well, that means we're doing our job.
Maybe a little too long. Can you drop us off, Mom? That's gonna be my son.
Exactly.
Just truth.
Not when that comes.
Right. I'm just like, right.
Gotta
Mom, can you pick a hotel? You've been at a hotel before, right, Mom? Can you? What room would you get?
Right.
Say that.
What?
Like that's when Brandy's glasses fog up. She's like, I can't believe
I would
all
literally
this is happening right now.
Oh my God.
But I can tell just from your energy, you want that line of communication open. Yes. You don't want to stifle your kid. Like, don't do this, don't do that. Because we know all that does is make them go way left. So I think everything you're sharing right now, you're on the right path. It just feels conflicting and weird in those moments.
Yeah.
Off topic. Yeah. What was the song that made you be like, I want to do music?
Oh, for me, it was seeing actually De La Soul come to my school in elementary school.
Yeah,
and
everybody got
to me. Yeah,
that's exactly where you go to school.
I went to school in DC, in a DC public school at that. Yeah. And but it's so funny because I saw Maceo years later, and he remembered coming too. He said we did that every year, so. Yeah,
just one time thing.
Our childhood sucked.
Billy Ray Cyrus.
It was De La Soul when they were touring with Stetsasonic, so Prince Paul, and I think what's so funny is that JJ Fad was on that tour, but it didn't really even make sense because they weren't even popping like that. But that's okay because you're on a tour with De La and Prince Paul. But that was that for me. It was like
our schools sucked.
Yeah.
I don't think y'all heard me. I said Billy Ray Cyrus was at my shit, so you can tell that.
I heard you. I was sad for you.
I was sad for me too.
My achy breaky heart.
Yeah, it was around that time too. That song was popping.
Everyone
was in the school doing a whole line dance and looking at me like, "You gonna join?" I said, "Nigga."
You couldn't have told me we would have had to deal with like four generations of popular viruses.
Yeah, exactly. Lord, What a trend that set. That
time, if I would have known, didn't I would have assassinated his ass in that gym.
No!
If it would have saved us from them, yes.
Not them, because we would have never got the glory that is Old Town.
The horcrux of mediocrity.
The horcrux.
We would have never had little Bozak the way we did.
Right. He's like, you know. No.
One time. That's all it takes. Stops all that. Exactly. Breaking heart. Wrecking ball.
Not stop all that. What's funny about you even saying that, and I think you can attest to this, just I'm pretty sure as long as you've been doing music and paying attention to it, if it wasn't going to be Miley, it was going to be somebody else.
Yep. Yeah.
There's always that to occupy that space. It was going to be somebody else. Yes.
Trifling is a trope that is, it's a, we got to have somebody be in that. You're right.
Yeah, that's true.
Unfortunately.
Vanilla Ice.
Very much. They don't do that when it comes to what we consider greatness, because not only do they only allow two people to be on top so much, even with men, especially with women.
Yeah.
It's like we can't all collaborate on the same song. We can't all go on tour together.
They need the hot thing at that time.
Yeah, that's it. And then if somebody else starts to rise, oh, you must be beefing with Nicki, which means you're beefing with Kim, which means you're beefing with Remy, which means it's ridiculous.
Exactly.
It's ridiculous. When really everyone's talented in their own bubbles. I want to know who you'd want to work with, like, right now.
Ooh, boy, like, in a, like, mainstream or, like, anyone?
It could be underground.
Let's start anywhere. Yeah, let's start anywhere.
Shucks. I mean, I have always wanted to work with Jake One. That's such a, like, underground thing to say.
No.
I like Jake One, though, and I'm such a fan. Sky Zoo is somebody I also, both of them for sure, I want to work with. I have enjoyed both of their music forever. So I feel like it's just kind of, I put it out in the universe. It just needs to happen.
If you work with Sky Zoo, you might end up crossing paths with Little Brother. You never know.
Exactly. You know,
it's the whole Justice League has a close
relationship with people here in DC. So it would be an awesome collab because he, one of our beloved sort of, you know, you have those ancestors of hip hop in your community. Shout out to Akil Nadir, Cool C Brown, who went to school in North Carolina with them. He was roommates with Fonte. And so his style, like Fonte's style, we always joke a little bit to say, it was a little bit, you know, kind of, you know, Cool C Brown rubbed off on him because he had that style and the singing, the kind of rhythmic, the patterns, all of that was like, he was doing that in 95, 96. And then he sadly committed suicide. So we lost him in an untimely way, but he was definitely a pioneer here in like the DC area for hip hop, especially that indie kind of, you know, indie style, because everybody loved his stuff, you know?
Right. You spoke about aligning earlier. And do you see a parallel between hip hop and geek culture, blurred culture?
It's inherently so. I tell people that it's embedded. Hip hop is inherently embedded in nerd culture. And I say that because the idea first of aliasing yourself, you know, the idea of that, like your rap name, your stage name is an extension of who you are forever. You know, there's been nerd and geek references and pop culture references and anime and Japanimation and comic books in hip hop. And that's in the mainstream and the underground, and even more so in the indie hip hop community, even more so. I mean, people elevate MF Doom, but before he was even MF Doom, right, he was in KMD, and they were very much a nerdy kind of a hip hop group, sort of on the fun party side. Think of Beastie Boys is very much similar to that. And then I think about the fact of like the metaverse of hip hop, like when you start getting into the idea that there was a multiverse in hip hop, there's so many things that intersect. And, you know, obviously groups that come together and you think about like, you know, AC Alone and Freestyle Fellowship, or you think about Wu-Tang and all of the tentacles off of Wu-Tang, that, you know, 75 different groups and producers and fronted things that come out of that. So I always feel like it is. It is. It's just naturally inherent in everything that is hip hop, especially if you think about gear nerds. I mean, there is nerds, producers that are such gear nerds. They study down to, you know, what particular equipment has a certain sound, has a certain hum, because they're trying to get that hum. They're trying to, you know, the idea of putting swing on your drums and, you know, being able to really think about how you're manipulating sound and samples and all of that stuff. There's people who are down to the snare, can tell you like where this snare comes from and how it's used and where it's used. So I'm like, it's just kind of like, to me, hand in hand.
Okay. I'm going to play another track.
Yes.
And I want you guys to check this out.
Toe sipping in frustration, head straight in names and mention my redemption. Torments the forces of all that I was. Thoughts unravel gauze, lace wounds and sores. Of course, friends withdraw confused. Left the crew, never felt this before. Scattered like remains of ashes on the sea floor. Past a detour, hard to find hope or stay afloat. When the world closes in like an end quote, I told a line like pin strokes. I will share the burden, but the bird is only heard when it's hurting. Still I'm learning, putting work in. Consequences averted, chasing stars, space and applauses for merit. It's apparent that the meek shall inherit the earth. Speech incoherent, check the current verbiage. Disparage that hits the surface beyond the epidermis. What's my purpose? Move as fluid as the verses. The universe immerses in shifts and urges. Life's a series of gifts and curses.
Sometimes I
with my birthright, I earned a burden. And now I move the currents with the rays of a curtain. Changing vibrations of migrations, a product of divine nations and standing ovations. When time paces, I create oscillations, pour libations. I lap lines like a conversation. It took a little patience and some innovation. Seen many faces, been plenty places. I'm driven to live every second like it's ending. I lost a few to transition. They overlooked the mission. I skate the distance in a figure eight position. Call it a premonition, even forward precision. Dance with the rhythm of old traditions. I'm on a solo mission with no competition. My pursuit decided, but the view was hidden. The expedition I was given, it never came with inscription. There was no booklet written. A few times I fell in love with bad decisions. Sometimes I learned a lesson and sometimes I failed the mission. Still I'm unrelenting. I pivot and create a composition. So enriching, my friends know the vision. They've been in the trenches. When we hit the benches, it's all vicious. The team ambitious, I miss them, even the criticisms. Whenever we leave, we possess in the whole position. Squad never fraud, never your weak heart. So with these quads, I proceed to please God and wreck chaos when we charge.
Sometimes I find myself.
Consider me a beast. All friends press delete to find peace. lost everything among the feast. When we excavate the damage, we find hunger in the famine. Examine the violins, violins playing silent hymns. Blinded by the spin, it's the whim, the fancy of the grin. I looked within, found light, but it was dim. Now I blend into the planets, peering through atoms, something to feel. Will to will is your strategic advantage.
That was Prowess to Testament. That was Wheel to Wheel. Need to check her stuff out. Hold on, let me get you together real quick. Let me get her going, because that was most definitely. So okay, y'all can calm down. I didn't pay you that much. they can get a little. There we go. Yeah.
More deserve it.
Yeah, you know.
Ones on top, but they
suck. And they, you know.
The voice. Is there a bit of a transformation before you hit the booth and or before you do a show? Because I feel like there's a different kind of voice.
Energy.
Yes.
Yes.
You know, it's a lot more deliberate.
You know, yes. Like,
take no prisoners. I'm about to mess some stuff up. And I hear it. And when I listen to a rapper, that's the first thing I listen to is the either the energy in her voice or the pain in her voice to see, you know, depending on the song. Like, I mm-hmm. see that in your song. So do you feel like a transformation happens?
I think so. I feel like I don't know when it does because I have immense stage fright. So much I can't eat or drink at all. Like, I can't eat or drink at anything. I don't care if the performance is at midnight, 2 a.m., till it's done, because I get that sick.
See, I don't, but I listen to. I don't get that, and that's
exactly. Like,
and that's why I ask that, because listening to you talk, and then mm-hmm. listening to you rap, I can tell the difference.
Yeah,
you know what I mean, there's that. Now I'm not gonna say timidness when you talk, but I can tell. You know, there's a little bit of anxiety, a little stage fright. When I hear you rap, yeah. I'm like, oh, that's where her confidence is at. That's
yeah, right. Song.
Yes,
you know what I mean.
It is very, I mean, speaking of like comic book culture, it is kind of very much putting on that, you know, after dark face. It is kind of being able to just, so yeah, I feel like there's a transformation that happens and the energy that happens with that. I don't know. I don't, like I said, I don't see it happen. For me, it just naturally, when the mic turns on, it's just, I even noticed because my body language changes, right? Like how I stand, how I, you know, what, how I move and all those things, my face changes. And, you know, I go from, you know, just from, like you said, it's kind of more shy kind of a appearance. And someone recently told me, it's very much like he calls it a velvet fist and an iron glove. And that is very much.
That's dope. I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
that's
yeah.
dope. That's a dope yeah. way to describe that.
Or no, iron fist and a velvet glove. Sorry. Because it's, you know, it's like just in the package of it being velvet and soft, and you assume that, like, oh, you're going to be really soft and nice when you get on the mic, and you're going to, you know, Malibu Barbie raps is going to come out, and there's just, yeah. And then he's like, all of a sudden, it's just this punch, punch, punch. And that, it does feel that way sometimes when I get, because I, for me, that mic is an opportunity to, the first time I picked, you know, did a like a performance or something like that, I didn't know how to hold the mic properly, you know, so I'm cuffing the mic. You can not hear me. And it was the first time that I saw, I went with like my boyfriend, you know, it was like, I didn't really know what I was doing, but then I was like, he don't know what he's doing either. So what makes it, what makes him better than me? You know what I mean? Like, let me just pop up there and see what happens. And we were, you know, it's like 16, it's an open mic or something. And at the time there, you know, this guy comes over and says to me, like, first of all, you need to put that mic right in front of your face. Forget them. I don't care what they do. Like, no one cares. But you actually have some, like, I wanted to hear everything you said, because when I would catch pieces of it, it was miraculous. So you need to learn how to hold that mic, because you learn and figure out how to get that voice heard. Because, and so for me, I feel like that guided me. And at that time I saw this another MC named Lioness. I was from Richmond, Virginia. And she changed my life forever, because I'd never seen like a woman rapping in person. You know what I mean? Like, I'd seen Queen Latifah and MC Light and Lauryn Hill and Bahamadia all on screen. Wow. I'd even been to shows, but it wasn't like what she did. And she was surrounded by, like, she was in this group called Tribe of Judah. It was like all these Rastafari, and she's in the middle. She's like the smallest, most timid person. I had no idea. And she blessed out of the thing. I was just like, and everything was like a Ginsu hit me. It was just like, what does she just do to me? You know, and I was obsessed with her. After that, I was just like, my life was never the same. And I recently got a chance to tell her that, because a friend had found her, you know, he lives in Richmond. He had found her recently, like, you know, you re-find somebody. She is not actively all the time kind of out and about anymore, like most people are during the pandemic. So it was really dope to be able to share that with her.
And see, it's amazing that you say that and what DC brought up, because I've been listening to you for quite a while, and I told you before the show, I said, you're giving off to me, you know, your vibe is like very much like Jean Grey, the lyricist Jean Grey. Mm-hmm. And I felt that. And when you mentioned Bahamadia, and I'm like, yeah, all that reign of women,
yeah,
in hip hop, that's the vibe I get, you know, when you out there and you're doing your thing. So that's why, you know, when you say you like, you're kind of shy, you get stage fright. I'm like, well, it don't show. Yeah. it's like why I go to
such a focused place, and I feel bad because people are, I've learned to kind of adjust to it now, but right, people like to sort of talk to you and engage with you before the show, and hee, and I'm very, you know, someone said to me, like, you're very focused on that's like, that's right. I am, because until I get a chance to unveil the flower, I can't. It's almost like I don't want anyone to unveil it to earth. Like, the energy can get swayed. So I just kind of protect my energy until I can get there, be, you know, focused.
Yeah. MC Brooks says Bahamadia is criminally underrated, and you are correct. Yeah, you are absolutely correct.
Another great artist and fellow Blerd, who was he performed at BlerdCon.
Oh.
Yeah,
that's why his name was familiar. I'm like, I know how to heard that name. Okay, you got a question, D?
No, I mean, I just I think what she said makes sense. As like, you know, it's sort of like an athlete who's getting ready for like game seven, and like, you don't want to talk to nobody. You just want to be like, I need to focus. I'm in the zone. Like, just let me veg out. Let me vibe out. We hit this court, and I'm gonna show y'all I'm ready.
Yes.
I feel like that's how you approach every show, because I can hear it in your voice. It's like, I want to talk, but I'm too singular focused on giving y'all the best show. So just let me have that moment to just.
Absolutely.
I've been there. It's like that for a show. It's just like, give me 15 minutes. Let me just
breathe.
Yes.
Get it out.
Because a lot of people talk about that part. You know what I mean? Everybody talks about the shows and after the show, but the preparation is a part that excites me, because there's so many similarities between actors, actresses, rappers, and sports stars. You know what I mean? Because it's just that preparation if you put the time into your craft and you give it your all, you're going to get back what you deserve. You know, a lot of people don't prepare. They just jump on stage and try to do a show, and it's just like, dog, you didn't warm up. Like, you didn't stretch your vocals or nothing. You jumped out and pulled a hamstring in your voice. Now you sound like Ray J. But you know, that's neither here nor there. I'm just saying, like, sometimes you gotta,
you better drink. You gotta drink the tea.
Yeah, you gotta stretch your throat, bro. That came out wrong.
You gotta warm up the vocals.
Like, you gotta warm up. Like, you can't just
call somebody.
You can't just go out here cold and just try to think you're gonna do something. Like, I like that preparation and just knowing the similarities, because I coached football and stuff. So just hearing that preparation that goes into it and that transformation before you hit the field is
the
vibe that I noticed all so well. You can hear it in people's voices. You can hear it. Like you said, that transformation, I've seen it. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
that's why I asked that question, because I'm like, listening to that song, I'm like, I can hear the transformation in her face, her voice, and her body language is different.
And that point was so funny. That song is called Will to Will. We just played it comes from a film called Valentine Crush that, you know, they asked me to make a song about roller derby. And you think about, like, it is a, you know, roller derby very much has a large presence of women and non-binary kind of talent that's in the space. And so this album, the soundtrack for this roller derby film, it's like a thriller film about this woman, Vicky Valentine, who gets kidnapped by a fan after she kind of pushes all her friends away. And then it's, you know, it's a very interesting kind of thriller about what happens next when she's locked in this room and this, you know, crazy fan is trying to do harm to her. And anyway, song was supposed to evoke. And I didn't realize at the time, and Chris, I kind of told you this, but I made that song right after BlerdCon.
Yeah.
When it was like, what happened to me when I was kind of this intimate partner violent stuff. And like all us, some of my friends were like taking that person's side. So it was almost like a self-fulfilling prophecy a little bit. And a lot of the energy that I was feeling went into that song.
It shows. That was very... had a lot of venom to it. But again, like I can do when, but that's the thing about it. When a person is putting themselves into it and they're trying to convey an emotion, whether you know whether they're trying to what emotion they're trying to convey, if you can hear it or feel it in their voice, that's how you know that person is one, either passionate, or two, really hates somebody very much.
Yeah. And it might be a little bit of both. So
yeah, but a lot of rappers don't have that ability to convey those emotions with their words and their inflections, and you know what I mean, just a simple twist of the mouth can change your whole delivery. Everything. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
it gets you, like, you know, people don't think about that when they're talking or doing public speaking. Like, it's not what you say, it's how you say it.
Yeah,
yes.
Is what we've learned through life. So you might mean something one way, but you get to twisting your lips and getting the, you know, body language, you'd be like, damn, he's really mad at me. You ain't even mad. It's just,
yes.
You know, so that's what I picked up on in that song. Like, I can hear those changes, and I find it dope. You know,
awesome.
It's very psychological, and people don't realize that.
Yes.
And the psychology of it is just like, when you're able to express that, you're in tune with your you know, yourself. And your emotions, and it's just wild how many people don't realize that. Like,
yeah, mm-hmm. Yep.
Who were your? You mentioned Bahamadia, Queen Latifah. You know, yeah. What other female lyricists were your influences?
Heather B. Paula Perry. It shocks a lot of people when I say this, but Lil' Kim is probably one of the biggest influences for me. Because I felt very akin to her journey. I mean, Missy, you know, who Missy has always been, but Lil' Kim more than so much, because I felt akin to not the journey, you know, the personal journey, but like as an MC kind of being, you know, she was kind of tucked small away from stuff. It.
Yeah.
And people, and assuming, you know, and it's just like, then all of a sudden this 4'9" person, and she's a giant of a person on stage. Yes, she comes alive in the booth, you know, it's a whole new Kim. And this sweet person who's, you know, kisses everybody on the cheek and hugs everybody and loves everybody and cooks dinner for everyone is not who you see in that booth. And I felt, you know, very much alike with her. I like a lot of the women in the indie scene, like Star, the MC, Psalm 1 when you know, she was doing her thing. Invincible is somebody who I really liked as a teenager. I feel like that was like Invincible and Eternia were really on the underground, like scene, working with everybody that I looked up to on the like male side. So it was just like, if you were an indie rapper in the early 2000s and you didn't work with one of the two of them, you know, you weren't doing
She's naming people that I haven't heard in a long time.
Yeah. Jean Grey, obviously. I feel like people would say, so it's funny because for so long, right, it wasn't that I didn't like Jean Grey. Well, I would go to open mic and that was the comparison. So I'd be like, oh. It was just like, and then, but I embraced that and I love Jean, and I feel like I even have a connection with her even more so because, you know, just the fact that like her dad is a jazz musician. My dad is a jazz musician too. And just, you know, the idea, I don't know, just kind of feeling very different bodied in the music and how she's so transparent. Like I can never do that. And so that is something, I think she's one of the most transparent MCs in hip hop across the board. Like for her, she can tell her story in a way, in a narrative way that you don't even realize she's telling her story. You know, it's like, wait, did she just say that in the middle of this? You know, that she took some pills trying to kill herself. Like you're going to catch those references in the middle of like a string of just bars that you're like, oh, wait. You know what I mean? So I like that about her.
Andy Brooks says, Invincible and Eternia both are criminally underrated. Eternia just dropped a new project last year. I'm going to have to hunt that down. Yep.
totally criminally underrated. I never think she gets her just due. And I feel like a lot of that's because she's Canadian. And, you know, it was just the turn of events or something like that. Because it was like, how did this happen? But she should be just as big. When people name Little Brother as being, you know, it's like she was killing them at that time in terms of like where her bookings and her shows and stuff. And like, and yet it's just weird. So misogyny. Cool. Hip-hop, you
know? Yeah. It's there. Unfortunately, it's there.
Yeah.
I'm going to play another track.
Okay.
So check this out.
They say that life is worth living when the living is good, but it isn't fun and games when the vision is blurred. Can't determine the measure of a man and only metrics, so we talk but can't walk a mile without feeling the pressure. From gospels of the savior to hostels our own payments, a lost soul without hatred and hopelessness is sacred. Down without a maze while I'm drowning in the pavement, my arrangement is tainted since humble days in the basement. My objective is selective, the message is affected. This track is my confessional, discretion unconventional statements express sentinel, the overdose eventual. Some call it spiritual, it lacks empirical. They fear it and pivot, it's mere image. It's the evidence of miracles. This melody is melancholy, wishing for a morning folly. How elemental are we? Blinded by ambition, my mission with the rim, but then again it's initial. Then I'm traveling like Michelin from here to Switzerland. So what's the difference in a sentence but the penmanship? Pick the poison of the pigment, just a figment of independence. I believe in vengeance, stack the remnants of those that beckon me. Stepping to me's a cause for heavy weaponry. Never a need, the seasons desert eat. Inevitably call me the cousin in sleep. I was born in the coordinator time. I've afforded it. This roof flame, this my ordinance. So when the audience goes silent in the performance, I keep a quiet orifice. This roof flame, this be a gift. We fall short of a dream, unattainable when you can grab it. Being average isn't glamorous, it's reality show cameras. You're nobody till somebody thinks you're established, and so suddenly you vanish. Abracadabra, you're a cadaver. First you have it, then it's tragic when you add it to the fact that it's the rabbit in the hat that attracts us when it's trapped. The escape is rarely shown. Does it matter when you're gone? I broadcast it from my dome, but I barely leave my home. Loose rocks fall and tumble, turn into some rolling stone.
stones and travel the hearse unrehearsed while I am holding poems. This gets swept away like dust in mobile homes and tropical storms. Thoughts form as brains seem to roam when the flock is flown and nested. One is left behind. The truth is set free with them and the dark will get the shining. I'm old school, Papa Cat like 79. Come and step like Petty Thief and then meet the cousin asleep, ayy.
That is, your style is undeniable. It is.
I gotta get it. Yeah. Different fierceness in that one.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah.
That was called Wolf Fang Fist.
Salute to Yamcha. So this was the reason I select that is because I also feel a lot in that song. I kind of talked about a little bit of fallen heroes, or I made some analogies to fallen heroes and what it's like to be kind of the butt of the joke, which Yamcha has just been so memeified in that way. But I think people forget about his prowess. You know, they forget about his strength and what was so incredible, that the fact that like he cannot Goku through some stone pillars. He's not like weak by any means, but you know,
damn near semi-pro on top of that before he became
exactly quite elite. Definitely one of the strongest fighters. And I think, but you know, losing, when you lose the ability to have that confidence in yourself, you make mistakes, and then you know you're not granted any leeway in this world to be, you know, redeemed. And right. So redemption is important. And you know, it's sort of like interesting that he's been dismayed, but for me is one of my favorite characters, because I feel like we all go through that. A character assassination does happen, and you make a mistake. You may not even really made a mistake, just somehow, you know, something happens and you fall. You know, that common line that I have, first you have it, then it's tragic. When you add it to the fact that it's the rabbit in the hat that attracts us when it's trapped, because people like to see people down. People like to see people in cage. They like to see them when they like to see strong people fall. You know, it's easy to root for everybody to say, I don't want Tom Brady to win. I don't. I'm rooting against Kobe.
You know what I mean? We've heard him do it, too.
Yeah.
We've heard him do it. So yep. This is from the family G Black. He did the intro for Blerd's Eye View. G Black blown away. He's blown away.
Oh, wow. Well, I love his intro. I was wondering who did that, because I was like, yeah, that's a crazy intro.
Yeah, he did the intro for us, and I can't big up him enough. Who have you worked with? Because if I'm not mistaken, you've worked with the philosopher himself, KRS-One, if I'm not mistaken.
I was named by him. So this is a quick story, but I applied to be on, he had an audition process to go on tour when he was doing Temple of Hip Hop tour, like 06 or 07. and he had he was asking for, you know, talent to he came to he was going around city to city. He came to DC, and these two women I know, shout out to them, DJ Soyo, DJ Earth One, were like, Prowess, you gotta be in this, like, you gotta be there. Make sure you're there to audition. When I came through, it's like a American Idol audition. It's that many people. But they were like, we got you, you know, don't worry. We gonna put you where you need to be to perform. So I get, you know, an opportunity to get on stage. And, you know, as Deezy said, I'm like, I'm shy, you know, so I'm not really good at like putting myself in spaces. And I'm sitting there kind of, you know, figuring things out. And my friend, shout out to Flex Matthews, was like second in line, or he was first in line, I think, or second, one of the two. And he takes and he grabs me and moves me in front of him. He's like, nah, you're not going to be, I don't know, 300, whatever number you are, you going to be in front of me. And we grew up in the open mic. We would, you know, if like freestyle together. It's called a true school. And it's, you know, you learn how to basically freestyle. You know, you get a card as they tell you to freestyle these words and all that. Then we have all these challenges. So it was somebody who, you know, I respected a lot. And I was glad he put me on there. I got on stage to rap. And as soon as I get on stage, I had like these, you know, shoes, one of my shoe comes off, and I'm like, oh my God. And everybody, you know, they're sitting and it's like a bunch of old dudes in the, to be fair, like my dad's age at that point, you know, and I'm like, oh my gosh, these people with their kids in audience. That's how, you know, I'm like, they're looking at me like, this ain't the teacher. We didn't sign up. Who is this girl? Get her off, you know? And I knew at that point in time, like, you better kill this. Like, you have never killed anything in your life. And I just started, I would forget the song. I'm DJ, cut the beat. I got a cappella about my shoe coming off. So I did that. And when I got off stage, you know, KRS was like, that is what you call prowess. You are what prowess is. So that's how I got my name. Prowess. I added the testament because people used to say I was always like preaching. I don't know what that, when I was in high school, they would let me preach, you know, so it was like, I wasn't preaching. I happen to have that very much. I don't know, when I talk, it's commanding. And sometimes.
So you heard that out there, people. She was named by the master himself.
Yes. And I was like, I remember, you know, on the side, I wind up getting picked for the show, myself, Flex Matthews, and one other guy to be on the tour. But I was like 18. I don't remember. My mom was not going to allow me to go. I was in college. You know, it was like,
yeah.
Who is this
cat? Destroyed.
You going with KRS? This man don't need you to tour.
Right. Who is this Chris One? Who's this?
Yeah. And the first, you know, you had to like get your driver's license, you know, do a 1099. I didn't even know how to do that. You know, my mom is helping me fill it out. She was like, what are you doing this for again? And it was like, because I'm touring, you know. So I didn't get a chance to go on that tour. I don't know how much it would have changed my life. Because after that, Flex Matthews, shout out to him. He got like Vans Warped Tour after that, a bunch of stuff. And Modest Yahoo, he worked with him after that. But like, so who knows how my life would have went maybe if I went on that tour, but it was the opportunity that changed my life, I like to think, in that moment. Because Big Daddy Kane was standing there when I got off the stage. So it was like, I got to perform for these greats. And they were like, you know, standing there mesmerized with me. I'm the one mesmerized, like, what? So,
like, of all the people.
Circle. Yes.
Full-fledged circle.
Yes.
What? I was going to ask you, like, what was your low moment, but you know, the shoe, I don't think there really is one for you, because you managed, if it's involving the stage, you always managed to turn it around. Like, there is no,
I tried. There was one time I got into a battle and I was worried that I was going to flub. So the first, you know, you have two rounds. The first round I flubbed. Because I was like, wait a second, I couldn't catch the beat. You know, I forget what it was that played. And to this day, I feel like it was Onyx Last Days, because to this day, I still like, when it that beat come on, everybody watch out. I'm the most dangerous person in the world when that Onyx Last Days comes. Even the Aretha Franklin sample get me amped. I'm like, oh.
Because like, you know, Berserker Rage over there.
Exactly. But I flubbed in that first round, and the guy got me, and he had a bunch of women bars, and I'm like, you knew he was going to come, you know, you knew that that's what, when you step on the stage, like, you're battling a dude. So the second round, we got ready to come to the second round, it was just like, I used everything against him in that way of just being able to be like, you know, well, of course, you got bars for women, like, you know. Clearly, you know, we're but
like KRS once said, that's prowess. That's how you flip that around. You're like, yeah, that's all right. You might have, because I stumbled. It wasn't nothing you did.
Yes. So. I didn't want to be the person that, you know, and I learned that I was there with someone who I was dating at the time, who battled, and the audience booed him, and he started battling the audience. When the audience started cheering, because they were like, yo, when you do that, like, you had it, but you're not a one-to-one kind of battle person. But when you going at the audience, he was hilarious. Everybody was laughing because it was much more like a comical delivery. And they enjoyed that. But that's what I learned that from him, maybe the fact of like, even if you get booed, you gotta learn how to snap them back into your grace.
Yep.
You know.
Yeah.
Stage presence and command.
That's all it is.
Key.
Yeah.
I'm gonna play this other track and then we're gonna have something special right after this.
Awesome.
This way comes, my spit afflicted the district, awaken the nation. Still kids persist to test if the gift is a myth, and leave who wigs split like a eucalyptus stick. Tip your fitted for the omnipotent, pose on a Mount Olympus with a pen like I invented shit. The vividness is limitless. They tried to massacre the innocence, the sickness, ambivalence of penicillin. So all hail the indigenous. Carbon scriptures are in his linguistics, isn't descriptive. Participants might have missed it. I circumvent the verse with a coefficient until you pay attention. The cost of rising for inflation, this is prohibition. No crucifixion, that was fiction. They tried to pierce the rib, couldn't make an incision. Still technicians knew the prediction of the resurrection and get celestial type erections and challenge the law of physics with the bow of Idris. Flow too bold for low emissions. Who is it? Testament is something wicked, wicked.
It was chanting. Voices. Dozens, maybe. They were coming from in the woods. I could hear them. Loudly.
They trying to copy the drums. They didn't know I was the mother tongue. If freedom was free, I would have charged them for another pun. Seen a lot of things, some of my ancestors' dreams. As a son of a gun, my kingdom made your team one screen run. Flex wings with none, so you seen. Beat at the gums, pledge allegiance with nuns up in the labyrinth. Salute 21 cannons with savage. This is collateral damage. Prowess and testament, writing commandments on tablets. The canvas is lavish. My automatic is erratic. The adage is enigmatic. Don't try to mimic the line. Can't catch the acrobatics, ain't tend to crack like ceramics. Put the mic down, can't understand the apparatus. Let me reaffirm my status. Behold the Sabbath as I circle up through the stratus. I am Mother Moon, emitting light that ignites planets. God damn it.
And rhythmically, I didn't know what they were saying, but I could tell it was ceremonious. Like a hymn you hear people singing in churches. Except it felt dark. Violent, even.
Must have been the way it was raised. To strike fear on the stage like a penis grenade. Take a page out of my basic instructions before leaving earth to take it out of context. Phrases cause corruption. Fuck the outcomes, I'm here for the experience. I put more fear in men than girlfriends but late periods. While practice for the scrimmaging, the game is ass backwards. Set the tone for grim tactics, the testament. Pissing on them seas like toddlers and wet mattresses. The brakes is aerosol, the spit spray like a matchstick. Throw lines and blow spines, still I leave them backless. Cremating seams and degrade the ashes. Use the residue to write classics. Somebody should have told him it's disaster. Word master, serve bars on platters that hurt rappers. Got the streets peaked like a purse snatcher. But rhetoric you thirst after.
The fear. I knew in my bones that the chanting was coming from there. What scared me the most was that it wasn't far off. It wasn't far at all. The chanting went on for hours.
Something wicked this way comes. Something wicked this way comes, comes, comes. I hope you go and get your gun. Something wicked this way comes, comes, comes. You're only gonna get one turn. Something wicked this way comes, comes, comes. I hope by now that you have learned. Something wicked this way comes.
Woo! DC, what you got? Because it's hot. It's so hot. Okay, y'all can calm down. You know what? Yeah, give it a. Okay. You mute it. Unmute.
There we go. There I go.
Okay. Oh,
my bad. I was saying I was scared. That was a little different of a transformation on that
one. Oh, yeah.
She
that was definitely.
Brought a little bits and price on that one. I was like, oh.
Yes. That one was meant to feel. It's so funny. I wrote that. I got upgraded to this wonderful penthouse when I was in San Juan. And it was, you know, I had these panoramic windows and butler service, all this stuff and I was sitting here writing that. And I'm in my, you know.
Oh, wow. You are a different kind of person. I'm not gonna lie, if I got a butler and panoramic windows, the last thing I'm doing is writing hate.
it was just a funny contrast because it was like it was the most beautiful suite ever. Ocean view, panorama, you know, it was just like I'm in paradise. I've never been in this suite like that again. Yeah, it was one of those.
You're lost in a maze.
Don't ever not tell that story. You need to lead with that story. Like this song was written in San Juan in beautiful clear, crystal clear waters. I can see the bottom and stingrays going by and cotton candy rainbow clouds and all that, and I was just writing anger.
Yes. It was funny because why did it come out then? And what I took that to be was that I was in my most relaxed space. I'm a literature nerd, so you know, I'm one of those
very Jekyll and Hyde of you.
Yes,
I'm about to say that's you relaxed.
Yeah,
it says a lot.
It almost doesn't surprise me because when she's keyed up, look how she is on stage. So when she's relaxed, you're just like,
"What's your sign?"
There's a third beast rolling around in there.
I'm not really sure. They say I'm a Cancer. Some people say I'm a Leo because I'm the last day of Cancer. Sometimes first day of Leo. So I'm not really sure, but I guess I'm both.
That makes a lot of sense. You torn between the fire and the shyness because Cancer is supposed to be shy and kind of, and then you have, you know, the Leos who are just brave.
That fiery side, I think, comes out. And so, the vanity and all of that stuff comes out.
G Black, he wants to work.
And that's why it's so funny.
I was shooting your info.
Please, let's work. I would love that.
Please.
Yes.
Please.
Oh, I would love
to see that. That makes so much more sense now.
Yep.
Did you say that you were right kind of in that, you know, listen to me being an astrological nerd. But no, being in the middle of that makes a lot of sense to how you can transform, you know, between both and have that fire on stage and, you know, command presence and still be, you know, kind of lighthearted off and, you know, I'm not going to say kind of bashful, but, you know, soft voiced and kind of, you know, even keel calm until, damn. Okay, that makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
So now you were just, you're just finishing a tour that you had on with Mark Cooper and yourself, and it was two other artists.
Shubzilla and Bill Beats.
Okay, yeah. How was that?
It was awesome for all of those reasons, because it's, you know, it's interesting that I think the three of Shubzilla and Bill Beats is a duo, and then Mark Cooper and myself. So it's very much the three of us kind of, I feel like are at that intersection with, like, really, you know, akin to the boom bap kind of very definite hip hop stuff. But at the same time, all three, you know, all nerdy kind of very, you know, content, and we all like the same stuff. And it's interesting that I feel like the three of us together kind of more on the traditionalist perspective of hip hop. Kind of combining our efforts, which is really, you know, put us in an indie hip hop space as we're touring. We really connect with those fans in a different way that sometimes feel like they don't connect to nerdcore, because they're like, we feel excluded from that because we may not know this property that you're rapping about. And that makes me feel like I don't know, right? I remember sending my Shubzilla and Bill Beats, shout out to, they made the Belmont tapes. I remember sending it to like an indie hip hop blogger, and he was like, "Ooh, what do, help me. I don't really know anything about this franchise. Because I didn't play that game." And I was like, that's okay, because what you'll see when you start listening to this, these are songs that borrow elements from like Simon's Quest and like Dracula's Curse. They're not direct, you know, book report raps. That's what's so great about the three of us coming together. So I really liked being on tour with them, because it's, you know, I can extrapolate something from all of them and put that into sort of how I proceed from here. And I learned a lot, I think, in that tour of just connecting with new fans, where it was like, you know, connecting with the fan that really is not truly necessarily a fan. Like, they didn't know who you were before. There were people who came to see us deliberately, and then there's those people who were like, I've never seen you before, but I, you know, love you. And like, you know, I remember this one girl, like, she was just like, I'm so excited. And she had gotten a little tipsy and she did not want to leave that show. Her partner's trying to drag her out of the show to get her home. And she was like, bro, I want to just listen to you all the time. And, you know, I came outside and she was outside and she still didn't want to leave. And that kind of thing, you know, that's a person you connected with. Like, she's going to buy, she's going to talk, she's going to share something with me. You know, we're going to have an experience for a lifetime after this. And so that is the kind of stuff that I'm like, you know, you cannot, you're the people that come to see you, they rock with you because they know what you are capable of. But those people that had no idea that you were, that they're just like, oh, this girl, what's she going to do? And then it's just, you know, that, oh my God, I love you. You're amazing. I love those moments.
So what's next for Prowess the Testament?
So I'm working on, you heard the Wu-Fang Fist, the Yamcha themed song. I'm working on a DBZ themed album with a So-So producer, indigenous producer, who's Navajo Nation. And I think it's really interesting because a lot of people I don't know, maybe people recognize like how much DBZ is steeped in indigenous references and indigenous culture, the sacred water, all of that stuff, right? So it's just like, it feels very cool to be doing this project with him. And then I'm working on my next Sky God project, which is Legend of the Moon, which is a Sailor Moon themed project. So those two pieces. Yes. And then, of course, Fireproof. Myself and Mark Cooper make Fireproof. I'm the fire, he's the proof from Soundproof, and we came together to make a team. So we're working on stuff together, and so that's fun too. I'm looking forward to like when us combining our efforts is like something magical. So I'm looking forward to that.
We're gonna give them a tease from we're gonna give them a tease from this new album, and if you people aren't on board with this woman, what are you doing with your life? We're gonna play it right now. Here we go.
Foes can't shoot through my open toes. I close lanes, mentoring the open road when I open shows. Change your channels, grab remote controls. Overload for hopeless souls who know we're dope disposed. Like drones filming overdoses of smoking bowls. Keep the smoking pros, causing social woes. And show no emotion like gold masks with a poker pros. When I talk these poems, these words cut out like broken homes. These vocal tones, smoother than Papa was a golden stone. Yeah, in other words, dope fiends for quote sings. Every time I spit a verse, bars start eloping. Compound so mean to pro tools and proteins. Whole foods to codeine, wear them like some OGs. That's provoking your whole team that I'm insulting. It's an omen, getting in line like coke stream coating. I'm ODing, this just OPM. Bestowing blessings like confessions from the podium. Composing old food.
Today. Woman, will you turn your back on me? Oh, we
So that was Starsky and Hutch, but she's got one more in the can. Y'all gotta be ready for this one. This
y'all gotta be ready for this preview because it's a sneak one.
Yes. So here's the next one. Pull that up, and here we go.
When I was born, I was out of place. Cause I was used to holding stars up and out of space. Now I drop tapes with a designer face. Hold the suns and deserts, I was trying to chase. An eagle out of Venus, a fire through the rain. A race to date to my escape. To run in place, I think it's not a race. Lock the hair or two, I'm thinking, what would the Sarah do? God bless my ancestors in a freaking room. I'm saying, what would Sarah do? If a sheriff got shot, when you ever school. For Santa's alluded to biblical heirloom. My grandma would light a match to burn a feral shoe. I got helios in a parachute under Herod's rule. But I still inscribe inherent tools. And what is to inherit tombs? We are heirs to rules. Fluent in nuances, plotting stars of fluences. Sit the congruent ruins of foolishness. Avoid the rudiments. It's inclusive. You lack the tutelage, but room feet for the numerous students collected up in my uterus. Fruitful, the supreme court spread the hubris. And now my sons are humorous, so they bathe up in the luminous. Clouds are cumulus, the school, the bridge expands the tutorship. My tutors do the rip, the view is lit.
Check the big roll, learn how to conjure power in a display. You should catch the big play. I could turn a pin into a switchblade.
I am extraterrestrial, investable, a special remedy. Collect my revenues, premeditate my gate. Better shoes, I'm out ahead of you. Build a rubric, I'm out of stupid. My new with this, the way I'm doing it is all exclusiveness. All fortuitous, but any pursuitous. As many call, but you was choosing this. Food resistance, another moon is spoon and keep the euphemism. Give me pounds, learn.
Y'all wasn't ready for that one. Y'all was not ready for that one. And I swear they weren't ready for that one. Prowess the Testament. I gotta give this one to you. I gotta give you the big one. There we go. All right. After this, y'all gotta get the hell out of here. Not enough room in this office for all of y'all. All right. Y'all good? Y'all happy now? All right. Okay. Yeah. So tell everybody where they can find you.
On everything at My Name is Prowess. MyName. My name is Prowess. I don't like to spell Prowess anymore because I always feel like I like to spell my name because I'm like, listen, if you can't spell Prowess, you probably can't spell my name. So, my name is
Prowess. But G Black is like, no, bring it back.
Oh, wait till you hear the rest of the song. It gets crazy from there. I feel like the.
You know what? Just for the crowd and for G Black because he's family and I know what it is. We're going to give it to him one more time and then we're going to get out of here. We're going to get everybody closing. closing words. And for you, G Black, yes, definitely. And you, for you too, Mark Cooper. You too, yeah, bro. Hold on, let's take it. Let's take it right back. All right. Pull that up here. And all right, here we go. And here we go. One more time.
La, 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 la. When I was born, I was out of place, cause I was used to holding stars up and out of space. Now I drop tapes with a designer face, holding suns and deserts. I was trying to chase an eagle out of Venus, a fire to the rain, a race to date to my escape. To run in place like this is not a race, not the hair or two. I'm thinking, what would the Sarah do? God bless my ancestors in a freaking room. I'm saying, what would Sarah do? If a sheriff got shot, when you ever sue? The Santa saluted this biblical heirloom. My grandma would light a match and burn a feral shoe. I got helios in a parachute under Herod's rule, but I still inscribe inherent tools. They want us to inherit tombs, but we got heirs to rules. Knowing the nuances, blocking stars and fluences. Sit the congruent ruins of foolishness. Avoid the rudiments, it's inclusive. You lack the tutelage, but room people in numerous. Students collected up in my uterus. Fruitful, the Supreme Court spread the hubris. And now my sons are humorous, so they bathe up in the luminous. Clouds are cumulus, the school, the bridge spans the tutorship. My students do the rhythm, you were slip.
Check the big roll, learn how to conjure power hands to display. You should catch the big play. I could turn a pin into a switchblade.
I am extraterrestrial, the vegetable, the special revenue. Collect my revenues, premeditate my hate, better shoes than I'm ahead of you. Build a rubric and mouth is stupid. If I knew it, this the way I do it, it's all exclusiveness. All fortuitous, but ain't pursuing this. It's many calls, but you was choosing this. Food the system, another moon is spoon and keep the euphemism. Give me pounds, learn.
Just feudalism juices till it reproduces. Yes.
Oh my God.
Now this chest burst, the first birth, the child from other earth is.
Look, she it's there. Look, I know. To check that, check the new album out. Coming out soon. Got a date for it?
To be determined in August, determined. But I don't know exactly when yet. I have to. I might pull up.
Don't Beyonce. Be a don't rush. Don't yes, rush please, it. Please don't.
Take
rush.
Your time, Pastor.
Yeah. Beyonce could have had to do the July. She owns that for nobody. I don't want to be too close to that, right?
Okay, wait. Yeah. You don't want to mess with the Beehive. Yeah.
When the Beehive goes away and it's a little bit more quiet, and you know, and let Bee have her time, because it's gonna be all in the first few weeks of August. So,
yeah. That is. Whew. I'm so glad I was able to get my hands on you to come on the show, because look, I knew you had some fire, and Mark Cooper agrees, and so does G Black.
Yes.
So I appreciate you, Prowess, the testament, for coming on and blessing us with these fire tracks. I can't wait for Sky God, and I can't wait for that album to drop. I really can't.
Yes. I can't wait for y'all to hear, because it's definitely like, never know book report raps, but everything is obviously inspired by the Sailor Moon universe. And so if y'all know, you know, all the inner Shinshi have a song a little bit, like, you know what I'm saying? Which is why they're around me, in that I decided to not just include Sailor Moon, but the inner Shinshi as well. But yes, it'll be fun.
Yes. And if you don't know, my name is Prowess. All one word on IG and all the platforms.
All platforms.
Check this sister out. She is not here to play. She ain't here for play. Do not take her soft demeanor kindly, because she's quick to turn a pen into a switchblade, as she just said. DC, where can they find you?
I ain't answering that.
I forgot. You. It's hard for you to follow.
No, by now they should know where to find me. I ain't hard to find. I ain't hard to spot. Black guy, hoodie. I'm here. You can find us tomorrow with Kid Crispy, Lost Society, and the winner of the $1 Million Baby, the wave winning. He will be in the building, so we're going to be talking music tomorrow night. Three hot rappers. Well, one hot rapper, a rapping group, and another hot rapper. So, you know. And then next week is 2 years of what the shit being in your face. all over the place. So hopefully by next week, I'll have some great news, be able to share some stuff. So you got to tune in to hear all that. Instagram is there, I think. All that. Definitely want to
follow the internet.
No, thank our guests.
Oh, you didn't label the button.
So amazing. Definitely following you on all platforms. Definitely had some heat. Definitely love the transformation. You go from,
thank you.
I can't even say that how I want to say that because it's just gonna come out wrong. When you go from because I wanted to say hard to soft. I mean soft to hard, but it just didn't feel
but you know what I mean. When you listen to the old Sky God project, which was very much a erotic project that I never done before either. I decided to do that, but you gotta listen.
The name of that again?
It's an erotic project.
No, the name of it.
Oh, it's Sky God. It's my first series called Air, Air Apparent.
And where can I find this at?
It's on all the platforms, but it's a lot of funny fellatio references in there, and
I like jokes.
Yeah, a lot of that. I was like, when it got to, I remember I was performing a song, and then I say something like, "Eat, in a pediatric harem, savory treats, running errands," and that's like sort of like in pediatric, you know, obviously because I drink kids. Hello, so it's a, and this was referring to. Like,
damn it, Bobby.
It's all the
wait a minute. Okay, that went over my head.
It did go over my head.
That went over my head because when you explained what you said after you said what you had said, it didn't. Like, say that one more time slowly for the people in the back. Namely me.
In a pediatric harem. So when people refer to like a bukkake fest, I wasn't going to call it that. You know, you got to be like, it's a pediatric harem. Savory treats, running errands. So, you know, they're dripping,
Kids
eat, and then I say, I eat the serum, share it with parents, which is like an interesting thing because it's like, is there a cuckold? I share it with parents. Prenatal orgies.
This is the leaderboard. No, that is some crazy ass wordplay, and now my mind is open. I'm like
even more intrigued because now I'm just like,
well, no, because the way the verse she came with it, it was so out of left field. Like you don't think like what she said. I was thinking of something totally different.
That's that phantom punch.
Break down with you, man. I was like, wait a minute.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Hold on. But,
Mark just said it. The bars are across the field. Exactly.
Oh, like, she yeah. runs on that
people,
one.
Because you know what it was? People kept saying, and we can close, but people kept saying that when it was like the WAP songs, any song celebrating sex, they were like, they're weak. And I was like, you can be just as lyrical and rap about that. That has
you goddamn right. You just proved it. Shit.
Right.
Because what you said, I know we're supposed to be ending it, but goddamn, my mind is.
It's hard. It's hard not
now
to.
I'm thinking, like, what else are they hiding out here in these cities? God damn it. I've been lied to. Let's go. Okay.
Let's do it. Oh, man.
You can find
me on IG, Blerd's Eye View, all one word. If you go there and hit the link in the bio, it'll take you to all the social sites, YouTube channel, Twitch, Twitter, the whole nine. Be sure to hit that notification bell on the YouTube channel. You'll get more reviews from Fury's Reacts and Reviews show that I do offsite. And I have a couple up now. I'll be dropping a new one probably later this week. But go there, show your love, show your support. Prowess to Testament.
They're like, oh my God, this is terrible. Can somebody please find Ja Rule, get hold of this motherfucker so I can make sense of all this.
Exactly. I need Ja Rule right now to make sense of all this shit. I'm going to be up. You never seen him with a dude in front of the whiteboards and he's doing equations and shit?
Oh, you talking about Charlie Day?
That's going to be me tonight. Yeah, I'm going to be writing words on the board.
There is no Carol in HR.
Because that shit was so dope, but it was so over my head. I felt so old listening to that. Get off my lawn, guy, trying to pay attention. I was so in tune with music until you blew my mind with that one. This shit doesn't make any sense anymore. Nothing feels right. Yellow tastes like blue. God damn it.
Prowess, the door here is always open. When you drop off the next volume of Sky God, please give us a call.
I will definitely be back. Thank you. I'd love to do a listening party for that. The show. Candy B, we missed you for a portion of this, but thank you for coming by too. Gotta always love my lady.
Oh, I'm pretty sure she's gonna reach out to you. I'm pretty sure. But I want to thank you for coming on. Everybody out there, like I said, follow us on IG, YouTube, Twitch, Twitter, the whole nine. It's all in there. If you just go to the ID channel, go to Blerd's Eye View. DC's still trying to figure it out. He needs a whiteboard. But tune in this Thursday.
It doesn't. I'm sorry. I don't the first time without the explanation, I was so sure of myself. I knew what was going on. And then when she broke it down, I was so goddamn lost.
Okay. Oh man, tune in Thursday. I have comedian Joey Purse coming on at 8:30 on the Blerd's React show. So tune in for that. Once again, Prowess the Testament. My Thank God, you. I can't end it without. I gotta give you another. There we go. That. This sister is, she's killing them. And if you're anything like DC right now,
perplexed.
You're probably perplexed. You're needing a whiteboard.
I feel like that's not a word, but it fits.
It fits. But like always, like I do every show, remember to educate yourself and others.
No, you're still trying to figure it out. No, we just leave them with what she said and let them think about that. Let them entertain themselves being lost like I am.
Oh, you don't want to feel alone in the lostness.
Yes. I'm a baby in the woods. Yes. I feel a baby in the woods. I feel like Donkey off of Shrek. I'm just out here just trying to figure out what the hell is going on around here.
Where's Donkey?
Yes. That's the best way to leave it, right?
Like, yeah, oh, man. You know what? On the strength of our guests, we'll just leave it at that. But remember what I always say. Just follow the show. Show some love.
What he said.
Go follow my name.
Her and think about kids running errands and copacetic. What she said.
We are out of here.
Thank you so much.
Oh, no problem.
It was awesome. I can-